Open your textbook page number 8. Now, look at this picture. Have you opened your textbook? Okay. Now, look at this picture. Here, the picture, it is a given of, map is given of India. Now, here, the shaded portion which is shown in your textbook, that is another plane. So, where the another plane is situated? Earlier you have learned about Northern Mountain, right? It's situated to the extreme of North India. So, to the south of this Northern Mountain, Northern Plains are located, isn't it? Now, we'll talk about the extent of Northern Plain. Talking about the extent of Northern Plain, it extends from Punjab in the west to the Assam in the west. Got it? Now, after that we will see the how much distance it covered by the Northern Plain. Now, if you will see the map, Northern Plain, somewhere it is a broad, right? Somewhere it is a narrow. If we will talk about the long distance, it covered the distance of 2400 km. If we talk about the width, as I said, somewhere it is a broad, somewhere it is a narrow. So we talk about the width of Northern Plain. So the width of the Northern Plain is 150 meters to 300 meters. Got it, my dear children? So what is the width of the Northern Plain? The width of the Northern Plain is 150 meters to 300 meters. Got it? After that, we will talk about the which state covered by the Northern Plains. So, the state covered by the Northern Plains are Punjab, Haryana, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, and the part of Assam. Come on, children, again you repeat with me. Which state covered by the Northern Plains? State covered by the Northern Plains are Punjab, Haryana, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, and the part of Assam. Got it, children? Now we proceed further. Now we see which rivers flow in the Northern Plain. Now the river which is flowing in the Northern Plains with their tributaries, that is Ganga, Yamuna, Satluj, Ravi, and Brahmaputra. Now, my dear children, tributaries, this term is new for you. So, what is tributaries? Tributaries means many small river which join the main river. Got it? Now, assume this is a small river. This all small river, they join to the main river, that is known as tributaries. So, if you look in the textbook, that many rivers with their tributaries flow in Northern Plain. So, again repeat, which are the rivers with their tributaries flow in Northern Plain? That is Ganga. Yes, put finger in your textbook. Ganga, Yamuna, Satluj, Ravi, and Brahmaputra. Okay, now one more new term is for you, that is a basin. Now, what is basin? Area watered by river and then tributary is known as basin. Now, my dear children, while flowing, all these rivers they carry along with them sand and silt, and they get deposited in the plain. So, because of that, that area makes the soil very fertile. And as you all know, this fertile land we can grow crop. So, in the Northern Plains, there are many rivers are flowing in that plain. So, that plain make an area very fertile and it's easy for growing crop. Hope you have understood this concept. Now, the second part we will see in the next video. But before that, my dear children, whatever I have explained about the extent, about the distance covered by Northern Plain, and then I explain about the state, and then I explain about the river.